How are folk going to eat? How are folk going to get health care? How are folk going to get to work?
Questions Samantha Davis desperately worked to find answers to the moment the coronavirus hit D.C. She says the local government is doing something to address those concerns.
However, it's never enough, right? And so that's the role that I play along with other organizers and community folk throughout the city.
DC Mutual Aid Network, Taylor speaking. How may I help you?
A coalition of organizations and community members launched a hotline as a part of the DC Mutual Aid Network.
We've been doing mutual aid for like the past 7 years.
To help create a rapid response to some of their neighbors' most pressing needs.
And recognizing that not everyone has access to grocery stores, not everyone has access to transportation, and not everyone can even leave their house.
The group is primarily focused on those living in Ward 7 and 8, communities where money, food, and resources are not always easy to come by.
I was hungry, and I know they help people out because I've been here before.
The group has stations set up all throughout neighborhoods and schools east of the Anacostia River, where people can get food, toiletries, and hand sanitizer. There are also volunteers who will deliver items to people who are not able to leave their homes.
We rely on each other. If we share resources, if we're building relationships with one another, then that is how we are going to survive this. This is how we're going to keep each other safe.
And look, you guys, safety is what this is all about. Making sure some of our most vulnerable people have the basic needs to make it through this pandemic. The DC Mutual Aid Network still needs donations like toiletries, food, and most importantly, money to buy what they need. We'll post how you can help on WUSA9.com and on our mobile app. I'm Michael Quander, reporting for WUSA9.